Hi, I'm Dario and welcome back to ND Puzzles. A new year has started and we invested into some new equipment, so I thought it would be a time for another build video. So today I want to show you how we built this two-layered pentagonal prism. This puzzle is based on the idea of our hexagonal tri-prism. Nico tried to design an even more complex version of that puzzle and chose the shape of a pentagon to get even more moving parts. The puzzle I'm showing right now was slightly modified by myself, as Nico's first version had even more pieces and I wanted to start with something that I could actually solve. Before I start to show you this puzzle in detail, I want to say that this is not the first version of this puzzle. Michael's son was the one who invented this puzzle in 2015 and called it the Pentet. We designed our puzzle without knowing about his version, but wanted to acknowledge his work by clarifying that he basically beat us to this idea by more than 2 years. The puzzle itself is pretty easy to explain. It has a main axis of rotation which allows you to move the two pentagonal faces. In addition to that, you can swap pairs of two corners. It turns amazingly well and I'm really proud of the finish, which in my opinion looks stunning. Although I keep saying this, I think that this is one of our best puzzles. Not due to an original idea, but because it has reached another level of quality. At the end of this video, I want to show you a solve which will give you an impression of the overall turning quality. But first of all, let me explain how we created this puzzle. After a pretty long print, which was caused by the size of the puzzle, I tried to assemble it to check how well the tolerances were chosen. On the cylindrical mechanism, there is only a small margin of tolerances that you have to hit in order to ensure that the puzzle is not too loose and not too tight. Compared to other puzzles, I found a good solution here. Being satisfied with this first test, I disassembled the puzzle again and prepared it for sanding. There are 12 pieces in total and I started to sand each of them individually. As always, I started with high grit sandpaper and continued my work with a file and that spongy thing. On the center piece, I also had to remove some leftovers of the support material and knocked off some sharp edges that I just didn't get the right fillets in the design. Swapping between several tools, you can get a pretty uniform surface. Once I was done with both centerpieces, I progressed with the 10 corners. Those ones have a hook similar to the one you might know from a 1x2x3 or a simple square one. They allow the pieces to stay in place, but also made it a bit harder to sand the surface below. That is necessary to reduce friction caused by the snake pattern you get when laying down filament. I experimented with some normal sandpaper and the sanding sponge to get around this issue and ended up using a combination of both to get the optimal finish. I finished the rest of the pieces off camera. Then I took my WD-40 out and bathed the pieces in plenty of that substance to darken the pieces and cure them from the grayish color they suffered from after the sanding process. After I was done, I felt very oily and the puzzle looked like it might get back its original skin color. So here's a short before and after comparison. After I had given this treatment to all of the parts, I was ready to assemble the puzzle again. It requires only one screw and is pretty easy to assemble. I just put those rotating corners into the corresponding holes and checked their movements. As you can see, it is a pretty tight fit, but still moves fine. To make it even smoother, I lubricated the puzzle. Then I continued to assemble the bottom half. Once that was done, I repeated the step with the other half and finally put the two layers onto each other and tightened them with a screw. Although I recently ordered a vinyl cutting machine, I didn't have it at the moment I was building this puzzle. So I had to cut the stickers by hand and went with a 3D printed template with questionable quality and stability again. I took out a pair of scissors, a pencil and the vinyl and started to produce the stickers. As always, this was a pretty time consuming process. That is why I'll skip a lot of it in this video. It already got longer than I expected and I'm happy that you managed to watch it until this date. When every sticker was cut, I applied them to the puzzle, which was a matter of less than 20 minutes. And voila, the puzzle is done. I'm really happy with the end result and think that it is a nice addition to my collection. As a final test, I wanted to see whether I could solve the puzzle. That turned out to be even easier than I expected. As the centers don't have an orientation like on the original tri-prism, you only have to swap around the corners, which can be done intuitively and without complex algorithms. Still, I like to solve this puzzle and I'm convinced that it is a great puzzle to give to family members or friends who aren't into twisty puzzles. Now, this is all I wanted to say to this puzzle and I want to thank you for watching this video. Over the next weeks we are trying to build some more complex puzzles and continue our OnShape tutorial series. So if you don't want to miss those videos, consider subscribing to our channel. I hope you enjoyed this video and would be happy to see you again next time. Bye!